Hi everyone, welcome to Soumya's Kitchen. So today's recipe is Malpua, and for Malpua we'll be needing sugar, water, milk, full cream, all-purpose flour and ghee. So this is about 1 liter of milk that we're using. So we'll take a pan and we'll add 1 liter of milk into it. And now we'll turn the gas on high flame. And the ratio that we're trying to achieve is 3:1. If we are using 3 glasses of milk, then we'll reduce it to 1 glass of milk and keep stirring it. So once the milk comes to a boil, then turn the gas to medium heat and keep on stirring it on the same speed. So this is the kind of texture and consistency we will have after reducing the milk to 1/3. And now we will let it rest and make sure the milk comes on room temperature and keep on stirring it. So now our milk is cool and it is thick enough. Now we'll be adding all-purpose flour or maida. So we are using about 2 tablespoons of maida in 1/3 liter of milk. Let it rest for about 15 to 20 minutes so that the maida is completely dissolved and absorbed into the condensed or thickened milk. And also the maida or all-purpose flour fluffifies itself, so that is mixed on a very good ratio. Meanwhile, in 15 to 20 minutes, we'll be preparing our sugar syrup. So for sugar syrup, we'll be taking a pan in which we will be adding 3/4 cup of sugar and 1.25 cup of water. The sugar syrup should be of medium consistency. It should be not thin and it should not be of thick consistency. Just make sure just keep stirring it very nicely. Once the sugar is dissolved, then let it boil for 4 to 5 good minutes. That our sugar syrup is ready. So now you can see we are boiling it for again 4 to 5 minutes as the water has come to a boil. Now by hand specifications you can look for sugar syrup consistency. It's very thin, it's not very thick. So our sugar syrup is also ready. Now for actual malpuas, we'll be taking a flat pan and we are adding about 5 to 6 big tablespoons of ghee. So on high flame, we'll just melt the ghee. We won't boil the ghee. We do not want the ghee to boil. Then on very slow flame, we'll be taking 1 tablespoon of the mixture or the batter that we made of maida and milk. We'll be pouring it into the ghee. So now you can say it will disperse itself into all together a round shape. And make sure that you cook this on a very slow flame, because by cooking it on high flame it actually burns itself and the taste is not the same. So make sure that the gas is on very slow and just make sure that on every side you cook it for 2 to 3 minutes. Then once you think that the malpua is done from one side, then change it again and cook it for 2 to 3 minutes on that side and on slow flame. So this is the kind of color and this is the kind of pattern that we are looking for. It will give a very orangish yellow color once it's done. Now our malpuas are ready. So by taking one malpua at a time, we'll press this malpua by another spoon or flat kalchi so that the excess ghee can be removed from it, and then we'll dip it into the sugar syrup. The sugar syrup should be hot enough. So like that, we'll repeat all the steps and we'll soak all the malpuas into the sugar syrup. Again, if while cooking malpua, any malpua is distorted or the batter that you've made is not consistent enough, you can take the malpua or the batter and again add some maida, around 1 tablespoon or half tablespoon of maida, and whisk it very nicely, and then again go for the malpua making. So that by that your batter won't be waste and your malpua will be nice and fluffy. Now we'll be soaking these malpuas for about 15 to 20 minutes minimum, and for serving we'll be taking a white fancy plate and we'll be topping it with some kesar and pistachios. Our malpuas are ready. So this is it, and this sweet delicacy is ready for you. I hope you liked the video. Give it up a thumbs up and comment down below what else do you want to see. Share it, like it, subscribe it, and go make it. Thank you.